welcome back to a new video. In today's video, I'm finally going to show you how I created the teddy bear nails, which I posted the short video of on Instagram a couple of days ago. I know some of you have been waiting patiently for it. Everything I'm using today is from SBD London. This foil, I think, is from one of their Galaxy kits, I think. And then I've got the teddy bear stickers and obviously the gel polishes. So yeah, oh, I love this set so much. I was really excited when I done this set. So I'm gonna start with Winter Wonderland 5. This is a gorgeous lilac, and this is gonna be the base color under our foil. So that's the first coat. These cure in an LED lamp for 60 seconds. Second coat going on, because you're gonna want to, well, because the foil's going on the top, you might not need two coats. I guess it's just, yeah, I just like to have that colour underneath, because if there are any gaps in the foil, then you're just going to see that purple underneath. But the coverage of the foil gel is pretty good anyway, so I'll show you in a minute. I'm going to cut off this little section here because I quite like this bit, because it had pink in it, purple in it, blue in it and green in it, which is all the kind of colours that we're using today. This is the foil gel that we're using. So a foil gel is different to a foil glue. The foil gel needs to be cured. So make sure you cover the whole nail, because we want the whole nail to be covered in this foil. So you don't want any gaps. So just check before you pop it in the lamp that there are no gaps. And again, this will cure for 60 seconds. So you want to put I like to use this. Excuse this, my finger looks dirty, but I was cleaning out my palette with acetone and it had gel paint on, and I got it on my fingers. So it's not dirt, it's just it's gel paint that I couldn't get off. Right, so the foil goes onto the nail. Put it on when it's warm, when it comes out the lamp and it's warm. I'm using the silicone tool to rub the foil onto the nail. Now, because the nail's curved, there are going to be sections that do want to sort of wrinkle up. But don't worry too much at this point, because I'll show you in a minute. See, that part there was a little bit of a devil. But when you take the foil off, so look, I mean, you get really good coverage already, but there are little lines in there that need sort of filling in. So all you do is just go back over with the foil. So place the foil carefully where that bit is missing, and then rub it over again with that silicone tool, and then that will just, what's the word, it will just fill in that gap. Yeah, there we go. And there's a few little creases on the right hand side there, which I'm going to sort out as well, but I'll do that off camera. And then look at these stickers. I think it's Vin Chen's nails, he's used these stickers in a set of nails. And I was like, there's no way. I honestly thought that he painted them on or something. And I was like, oh my God, they're nail stickers. But you know what? Nail stickers and the decals are really good for people who are not that great at... I'm not saying Vin Chen's not good at nail art, because he's amazing. But for those people out there who are not confident with nail art, nail stickers and the water decals are brilliant. I love them, and they're quick, they're so quick. Look, easy peasy lemon squeezy. Oh my God, someone said, probably tagged me in it, I can't remember who it was, but someone tagged me in a post, it said easy peasy or something, lemon squeezy, and said it reminded them of me. Oh, it was so funny. So I'm going on with the matte top coat now. I decided that these nails have to be matte. I mean, they don't have to be. I just wanted them to be matte. If you want them to be shiny, they will look something like this. I do like a matte nail. There we go. Oh, how cute are they? I used to love teddies growing up. I still love teddies, but I don't have as many. The only teddy I have now is my dog, Teddy. Right, Garden 2 is this blue. And I'm also going to be using Summer Shimmer 5. So we're going to create an ombre, not a horizontal ombre, a vertical ombre. Now, they didn't ombre together very nicely. I don't know what it was. Maybe it was just me. I'm not blaming the gel polishes. Perhaps it was me. but one side is going to be the blue and then the other side is going to be the green. And then I'm going to use my Born Pretty Ombre brush. By the way, you can get some money off Born Pretty website using my code. I think it's NMM10. I don't think I let people know very often, but if you're thinking of purchasing anything from anywhere, just check in the description box of my videos, because if I have got any discount codes, I'll leave them in there for you. And it just saves you a little bit of money. And some of them help me out as well, because I do earn a little bit of commission. There we go. So that was the first coat. The first coat doesn't have to be perfect, because we are going to go in with a second coat, but do try and make it at least slightly blended, because it does help. Oh, okay, y'all. Oh, it's still early. We've not long got up, but I wanted to do this because we've got to go and check in on my mum. So, I thought I'd do this quick. It's okay, we're in a bubble. Don't panic. Right, so this is the second coat, and we're going to ombre them now. I don't know what it was. They went fine. And again, I like to use thin coats when I ombre. I put a little bit of blue gel polish on the left side as well, because maybe I needed to do a third coat. I don't know. I'm just putting a bit of blue on now. But do you know what? In the grand scheme of things, I think I was worrying too much, because I'm going to put a teddy bear on the top of this, and it's quite a big teddy bear. And then also I'm going to put some crystals on as well. So I think I was just overthinking it. Right, I'm going to use this big teddy bear. Now, again, right, the nail that I used, the nail tip was quite curved. And when I put the teddy on, where the nail curved, there were parts of the sticker that wanted to wrinkle up. So do bear that in mind if you're going to use a big sticker. I think I probably would have used a smaller one. Look, can you see there's wrinkles on it? Well, every time I press those down with the silicone tool, like, they kind of wanted to pop back up again. So what I thought I'd do was this is the rubber base, because I couldn't find my other base, but this is the rubber one. And I'm going to go over the top of the sticker, and I thought this would smooth out any sticky, uppy, lumpy bits before I applied my matte top coat. And actually, it done the job, because I think it looked all right once it was, once it had cured, and once I'd finished the nail, or matte top coated it, because it's not finished, because we're going to put some crystals on. I was like, we need some crystals just to outline the teddy bear. And I got the perfect mix from Crystal Parade to show you, actually. That I thought would be perfect for this. See, look, once it came out, it's not too bad. You can still see, you know, a couple of wrinkles, but you have to look pretty close to see them. You know, if they're on someone's nails, you're not going to, you know, have their nail, especially not at the minute, because, you know, social distancing and all that. Right, Garden 8, we're going to use, yes, yeah, so Garden 8 is going to be, this is going to be a full nail. It's a really pretty pink. And then the other nail is going to be Garden 2. I think that was Garden 2, the blue one. I forget, honestly, I'm so terrible at remembering names of colours. So this is the first coat. We're going to apply 2. And again, they cure in the lamp for 60 seconds. So this is me applying the second coat. I'm sure you know, but I shall just say it, just in case. Someone in the SBD London group actually posted a really good... I've got them right in front of me here. They're like little swatch thingies for the tops of bottles. And they looked amazing, because a lot of my SBD London gel polishes are in drawers. I have been putting bottle swatches on, but they're facing the front, and I can't really see the front very well. So it's going to be really good to have the swatches on the tops. So yeah, that's going to keep me busy. It's going to keep me out of trouble. Right, now both of these nails are going to be matte top coated. What do I do on the... Oh, I do. Yeah. I know what I do. I was like, I filled the nails, but I couldn't remember what I did. Yeah, just ignore me. Okay, so that's the pink one matte top coated. We're going to matte top the blue one. We're going to sort this blue one out first before we do the crystals. So I'm going to matte top coat. And then while that's in the lamp curing, I'm going to take some of the green... the pink and the purple and place it on a just a little palette. So that's going to go in the lamp, but you have to top coat it first. So yeah, so here we go. We're going to put the purple and the other colors on the palette. But you can see one of my LED lights. I'm trying to work out what that's the arm of the, stop it, okay. That's the green. The green one's really pretty. Right, now using my Natalie Mugridge Nail Sugar Detailer brush. This is a 000 fine brush. I absolutely love it. I'm going to draw some hearts on with the gel. Now, I matte finished it because we're going to sprinkle this with acrylic. So the nail's going to be basically finished. So you want to make sure that you top coat the nail before you do this part. You can do it on a shiny nail if you want to. Actually, the matte hearts would look quite nice on the shiny nail, but I've just gone in all matte today. I wanted quite nice big hearts, like big chunky, like not, they're not big, but they're kind of like chunky hearts, do you know what I mean? There we go. And then once I've done that, I'm going to take some clear acrylic and I'm going to sprinkle that onto the gel polish heart. Now what you want to do is you want to wait a few seconds for the gel polish to suck up, to sort of soak in that acrylic. And if you don't wait long enough, you'll find that the gel polish will start to go shiny again. But once it's nice and matte, pop it in the lamp to cure and then brush off the excess acrylic. And then that's, I've done that, but I'm doing a green one and I'm going to do a purple, pink one, sorry, as well. I do cut, skip forward a bit. So yeah, like I've done a pink one and a green one. Yeah, pop it in, let it cure, brush off the excess, I was going to say glitter, acrylic, and you've got like a matte finished embossed hearts. So right, we're going to put some crystals on. Ta-da! Right, there's two crystal mixes in here. There's the sherbet mix, it's different sizes, and then there's the sherbet statement mix. I'm pretty sure that's right. And I thought, well, because they're all sherbet ones, I'll put them in the same pot. But actually, after doing this, I did decide to separate them because the big ones were very big. So I've put the big ones in that pot, and then these are the smaller ones, right? But you can see they're really nice, soft pinks, blues, greens, and yellows. They're really nice colours. And I was like, these are going to go perfect with these nails because they're just like, I don't know, it's like it's meant to be. So for the first one, for the teddy bear nail, I'm putting a little bit of glue, gem glue. This is the Crystal Totalist gem glue. I'm putting a little bit in the corner, in the top right-hand corner there. And I'm just going to place some crystals. I'm not zoomed in enough, but I've put one big one, two smaller ones, like top and bottom. And then I'm going to put one crystal just on the edge there. I will zoom in a minute, promise, so you can see. And I'm not going to put caviar beads on these nails. So yeah, look, there we go. I am just going to try and gently get off that X. There was a little bit, I put too, a little bit too much glue on. There we go. So I'm going to pop that in the lamp to cure. And then I'm going to do the same, but in the opposite, like the bottom left. So top right, bottom left. And just the corner. And then again, but this time I'm just going to put one bigger crystal. Then I'm going to put a medium-ish crystal one side. And then another one the other side. Making sure that colours that are next to each other aren't the same. I was trying to find one here. I was like, what should I put there? There we go. And then a smaller one either side of those. Just pick one, Nats, for goodness sakes. There we go. And then I will pop that in the lamp. And that will be that nail finished. So it's just got like a little crystal highlights. And then these are the bigger ones. These are amazing. So these, I think these are Preciosa. I'm sure these are Preciosa, and they're just beautiful. I just wish people would stop worrying that we can't get Swarovski anymore, because Preciosa are, they're amazing. I buy them over Swarovski now, unless there are shapes I can't get in Preciosa. Then I'll get Swarovski, but I honestly, they're amazing. I've been meaning actually since before Christmas to do a video comparing them, just so that you can see that they're honestly, they're just as good. In fact, I will try and do that video. Yeah, so right on this nail, I'm going to put four of the big crystals. So these are from the statement mix, and I'm using one of each color. So I've got a blue, a yellow, a green, and a pink. And then I'm going to sandwich those in with slightly smaller crystals from the other mix. If you want, you can cure this now before you do this last bit. The crystals did want to move ever so slightly, so I did have to keep like moving them. But you know, if you've got a bit of patience. I don't really have patience, but actually when it comes to crystals I do, because I absolutely love putting crystals on. There we go. And then I'm gonna make sure, so I've got yellow and blue at the top. I'm gonna make sure I've got pink and green, yellow and blue at the bottom actually, and then pink and green at the top, just so that the no colour next to each other are the same. And then for this now, I decided that I was going to put some caviar beads. These are the silver caviar beads from the Crystal Parade. If you want to get 5% off your order, you can do so using my code NAT5. But I think at the moment there is a 10% off code for Crystal Parade, because they've got a new website. And I think it pops up on a little window pops up on the website. You can get, but if you don't want to pop your name in, you can use my code NAT5. A saving is a saving. So yeah, I'm going to put some of these caviar beads between the crystals, just like that. And I'm going to finish this, but I don't show you me doing it all. So there we go. So that's what I'm going to do, but I'm going to do it on the whole lot of crystals. That makes sense. And then this is the finished set. I absolutely love these so much right now. I hope you do too. If you do, please leave me a like. If you haven't already, do consider subscribing. The website link to SPD London will be in the description box. I think that's it. Yeah. Okay. And I'll see you tomorrow with another set of nails. Love you all.